friends, so I welcome you in this today's session. Today we are going to discuss about the relationship between KP and KC. Okay, KC stands for the equilibrium constant when the concentration terms are expressed in the liters per mole, and KP stands for the equilibrium constant when the concentration terms are expressed in the pressure units. So let us start the sessions. Consider this general homogeneous chemical reaction in the gas phase. So the reactant A and B, they are in the gaseous states and they are converting into the product C and D. Both are also in the gaseous state. Now this reaction is in chemical equilibrium. What is meant by chemical equilibrium? It is the point or it is the state at which the concentration between products and reactants is constant. So applying a law of chemical equilibrium to this reaction, then we get equilibrium constant KC. Equilibrium constant KC is equal to concentration of product divided by concentration of the reactant. Now how to define the equilibrium constant KC? Okay, equilibrium constant KC can be defined as it is the ratio of product of concentration of products raised to suitable stoichiometric coefficient to the product of concentration of reactant raised to suitable stoichiometric coefficient, and this ratio is constant, and this constant is called as equilibrium constant. It is the ratio of product of concentration between the products raised to suitable stoichiometric coefficient to the product of concentration of reactant raised to suitable stoichiometric coefficient is constant, and this constant is called as the equilibrium constant. Okay, let us consider this is equation 1. Now for ideal gas, this is the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to nRT. The gas which obeys this equation, ideal gas equation, is called as ideal gas. So PV is equal to nRT, where P stands for the pressure, V stands for the volume, small n stands for the number of moles, and small r stands for the molar gas constant, T stands for the temperature. Rearrange this equation, take this term volume to the right hand side, then we get P is equal to n upon V into RT, and this n upon V is called as the concentration. Therefore C is equal to just rearrange this equation, therefore C is equal to P upon RT. Here concentration means, what is meant by concentration? Number of moles of solute dissolved in given volume of the solution is called as the concentration. Therefore C is equal to number of moles n dissolved in a given volume of solution. So n by V is nothing but the concentration terms. So we have just rearranged this equation, C is equal to P upon RT, and the meaning is we have given here below that. So always write the meaning of each term below the equation. Okay. Now this is equation number 2. So let us put this equation 2 in equation 1 to the respective places, then we get, okay, therefore KC equal to, look at here, okay, capital C is nothing but concentration expressed in liters per mole. If we express this in pressure units, then C is equal to PC upon RT raised to C. Then next term is concentration D. So concentration of D term will be PD upon RT raised to D, upon concentration terms for this A is PA upon RT raised to A, PB upon RT raised to B. Okay, इथे आपण काय केलंय, फक्त ही जी कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन टर्म आली आहे C is equal to P upon RT, प्रत्येक पेशीसाठी आपण काय केलेलं आहे, हे इक्वेशन प्रत्येक पेशी मध्ये आपण इथे मांडलेले आहे, C च्या जागी, D च्या जागी, A च्या जागी आणि B च्या जागी. ओके, नाव लेट अस टेक आउट द कॉमन टर्म्स आउटसाइड. सो प्रेशर युनिट वी हॅव टेकन आउटसाइड अँड RT युनिट वी हॅव टेकन आउटसाइड. So therefore PC raised to C, PD raised to D upon PA raised to A, PB raised to B. Okay, these are what the concentration terms in pressure unit of the products, concentration terms in pressure unit of the reactant. Okay, now here you look at that, here is 1 upon rt, 1 upon rt. So this will go to the denominator and this denominator will go to the upper side. Okay, chedacha chhed ha nehmi amsh asto, that we have learned in our schools. So we get rt raised to a, rt raised to b on the upper side, that is numerator side, rt raised to a, rt raised to b on the numerator side, and rt raised to c and rt raised to d on the denominator side here. Okay, so next up we can write this. So in school we have seen, we have learned that suppose a raised to x and a raised to y, these are the term, this is a product term. So then which is equal to a raised to x plus y, we can do the summation. Okay, paya saman astani ghatankachi beriz hote. Okay, standard 8. So a raised to x plus y, a raised to x plus y, and second rule we have also learned, the when there is term a raised to x upon a raised to y, then it will be a raised to x minus y. Okay, let us apply this to mathematical equations here. So equation will be rt raised to a plus b upon, sorry, minus c plus d. Okay, I have omitted one step. So therefore, okay, this term is equal to kp into rt raised to a plus b minus c plus d. Okay, and this is nothing but delta n, and delta n is, what is delta n? Number of moles of product minus number of moles of the reactant. And this is the relation between kp and kc. This is equation number 3. So here kp is equal to pc raised to c upon pd raised to small d upon pa raised to a pb raised to small d. Okay. So this is a 2 mark derivation, 2 to 3 mark derivation. So when the question is asked, then simply solve this, write down this equilibrium constant Kc. Okay, then write down ideal gas equation, then simplify this equation for the concentration term, C is equal to P upon RT, then put this term in this equation and just segregate the common terms. So here, and you derive this equation, KC is equal to KP into RT raised to delta N. Okay, so if you have any doubts or any difficulties, then please call me or you can WhatsApp me. So thank you for watching this session.